I remember when this were all fields. Back in the day, we were really rocking. Rocking like a ship on a storm-tossed sea. We actually were at sea for some of it. I don't suppose you'd like to hear about it.
Yes!
I think I'm going to need some help. Can you all clap your hands and stamp your feet? Like this!
See you.
hearted. If he started to charge our friends properly, we'd soon be solvent.
Oh, I know, Jim. And if we to be solvent, I know that you and I have to stick together like glue. And if we do, I'm sure our luck will change.
Oh, Mary, don't joke. Look, I think I see someone coming. Maybe he can help us out of this sticky situation. Let's all call for him.
Come on in, you lot. Come on, you lazy dogs. Here, lads, put it here.
That long seagull, that is very, very heavy.
Oh, what are you worrying about here?
Whatever you've got in there. Maybe it wasn't that bad for long.
It ain't no body, just me worldly goods.
Just one measly penny, worse than a collection of All Saints last week.
Show me timbers. This looks like an alright place to sling me up. Here, missus, you got a boat to spare for a weary sailor? Just for a couple of nights? Bit of privacy, no questions asked, mind. Just a spell ashore.
I think so. Yes, we have the perfect room for you, sir, and it comes with a bar.
I ain't fussed about it, baby. You won't. Come here. Got a joke for you. You got good eyes, good ears. Well, you keep a lookout for anything suspicious, and you tell me, right? If you see a blind man with one arm, got it? What are you gonna do?
I've got to tell you, if I see a blind man with only one arm, is he dangerous, sir?
Dangerous. He's harmless. All right, well, show me, you know what you've got to do. Now show me to my quarters, and give me some food, and get me some ale.
Hey, you, what a horrible man.
He'll bring us in some rent, so it'll be worth it, I suppose. Must remember to keep a lookout for a blind man with only one arm. Blind, one arm.
So that was how it all began. The captain was often drunk and grumpy, and after the first few weeks began falling behind on his rent. No one was allowed to touch the chess, and one day, when the pub was full of our village friends...
Thank you. died of fright. Shock bringing on the heart attack.
What is he so frightened of?
He looked sharp at the sight of Dame Pew.
Yes, but he did not collapse until my knee stuffed something on his hand.
Doctor, do you know what was put on his hand?
I do. I'm afraid to tell you, but it was the black spots.
But what is the black spot?
The black spot is an ancient pyro curse. Anyone may wish to punish by death, they'll deliver them a black spot, and within 24 hours, that person will die.
It seems that in this case the fear was enough.
Oh, I'm saying goodbye to my lodger and goodbye to all the money he owed me.
Mrs. Hawkins, please stop crying.
Oh, Mrs. Hawkins, please stop crying.
What about this, Mrs. Hawkins?
Oh!
Yes, none of us have ever seen inside it.
That's his old sea chest. It was too heavy for us to carry up to his room. So Captain Old Seagull asked Jim to keep a lookout over it for him.
Yes, and he also told me to keep a lookout for a blind man with only one arm. I tried to, but it was too late.
Well, you see, in these cases, I can, as squire, give permission to open the chest and examine its contents. But boys, please remove this body first. It smells.
It's not any good for life. And now get it worse.
Tell you something, I don't fancy this job for long, so all you lot stop complaining at me.
1, 2, 3, hey! 1, 2, 3, hey!
So now then, boys, let's get this open.
Winners and rich forevermore.
Change our dress code. Exalted holidays. courage in them to go on to Ditcot Girls' School.
Looking at some of this stuff, she's right, you need courage.
Of course I want to go.
And Jim, if you are going, then that means I am certainly coming with you. After all, who would get you up in the mornings, cook all your meals, make sure that you got dressed properly, put you to bed at night, read your bedtime story, and leave behind your ears?
Oh, Mother, lay off, will you? I can look after myself. But that is a good point. We need someone to cook a tea for us. Who else is coming?
Me!
Spotlesses, let's practice!
write a letter to my long-lost uncle to ask if I could stay with him. I don't even know him, just if he was a sailor and used to live in Bristol. Oh, there's still some miles to go.
That is how Molly and the dogs came to be a part of our adventure and a part of my life. The good squire made his way to Bristol Docks to search for a ship he could charter, while Molly started to search for an uncle who could adopt her.
Settle then. Now to business. I need a good sound vessel.
useful.
Seeing for you will be no problem, sir. That's what we're here for, ain't it, Har?
Aye, aye, Officer. Whatever you say.
Ludo, I'm going to tell the true man of honour and integrity the moment we met.
That's how we are, ain't it, Har?
Oh, definitely, Long John. Your honour and integrity could be your middle name.
Now then, your crew.
Thank you.
about this?
Oh, I don't know. If I play my cards right, we might net up more than treasure.
Hey, how did she play cards?
Oh, she's fishing for a new man in her life.
And anyway, Jim, the captain needs to know where we want to go.
That's true, Jim. Captain Slimmer, can you read this map and sail us there without delay?
Who's delay? We can't take all this and more. So it'll have to be without delay.
No, no. I mean as soon as possible.
This map is the one we've been searching for. It went missing when old Sea Dog did a runner to make a stretch.
Old Sea Dog? Did you say Captain Old Sea Dog? He was my lodger. He died and lived owing me vast amounts of money, and that's why we must find the treasure.
Died? Dead? You mean dead died? He's escaped my crutches. I mean clutches.
Clutches sounds rather fun.
Release the map, you see.
Release the map, you see.
all good people, even if a little weird. So I don't want to...
Hey, you two lazy neighbours, get back to work. You know what the politicians say, look after the workers. Well, I'll be looking after you two if you don't watch it.
Oh, Molly, there you are. I've been looking for you everywhere. Are you enjoying the voyage?
Of course. It's a great adventure for me. But there's something a bit confusing about my ankle. Something a bit scary.
That goes for me too, Molly. I don't mean I'm scared of him. I just don't trust him. I'm a little bit confused about you and I as well.
Stop bothering me. Returning me to the stations.
much you see the message?
What message? They almost swapped my bitch with the woman. Just told her to leave.
No, Longdon. They overheard some of the crew saying they don't trust you. Also, they heard that Mrs. Hawkins has the map hidden about her person.
Shiver me timbers. What a discovery! Plan our moves carefully. First, we need to get our hands on that map. We'll search the woman's cabin while she's asleep. We can get the little east to do that. Once we got our hands on the map, then I want you to, whenever you meet any of this village lot, give them the back spot. Whenever you meet any of them on board, toss them overboard. Right. Back to work and look normal. If you can look normal working.
Thank you.
Just to remind you, we're all together on board the Hispaniola. There's been a terrible storm when the wind tossed us about, the rain lashed us, the waves grew higher. We were fearful of our survival.
And I am unable to work.
And I come from the forest.
frog?
Yes, yes, and I have done the same to the giant swan. Yes, yes, that's the music. Are there any swans in our tree? We are very enthusiastic conservationists. Frogs, swans, a few princes, George, Harry, Louis, Archie, you name them, we've saved them from extinction.
Just in passing, can you sell some squid for your stores? They're really very cheap, but it's not very well.
How much is it then?
It's only 6 squid!
Must you stop it and be serious?
Then how do you count it serious? Genevieve?
Then you could be serious with that,
so, down to business. Is there anyone here who needs our help?
No swans, no princes, but we think we do need help.
We are in the collections of Long John Silver and his wicked band, and somehow we need to reach a particular island.
And apart from Mrs. Hawkins, none of us want to be in Long John clutches.
That goes for us all. Do you know these seas at all?
Of course, you silly girl. We swim these oceans all the time.
Which island do you want to get to? I'll find it on the sat nav.
I know the coordinates.
Oh, well, indeed. We know that one well. Quickly, if we all work hard, we may be able to reach the island before Long John Silver and his friends wake up.
Yeah.
So, Duncan Watts of Paris, Luca and Charles. Emma Williams. Marianne Dargy.
Gina Foote.
Evan Hawkins.
Esther Hamilton.
Catherine Brown. You can stand up on here. Catherine Brown. Gina Booker. Chris Brett. Noel Flip McCleary. Simon Mill. And Granddad Watson Harris. We're going to have to sing it all through first. So, ready? Everyone on your feet. Come on.
Thank you.
haven't seen the Hoover Pier this last 20 years.
20 years? It doesn't mean that long.
Don't be angry, we thought this island was deserted.
Yes, we truly did. Who are you?
You don't know me. My name's Ben Gunn. A dander I was. Cheater and left to die. Oh, because I wouldn't give away a secret. Morna!
Oh, no. Who did this to you, you poor old soul?
You wouldn't know him either. Terrible man. He went by the name of Long John Sliver. Terrible, evil man. He threw me ashore and left me to die.
Was that
just who we're with?
He's been trying to give us all the black spot.
He's with you, is he? Then let me at him. Is that the black spot? He's been trying to give you the black spot. Then you haven't got long. Aha! Don't give in to fear. Maybe some of my friends here could help cheer you up. Come on, you lot. Let's try and cheer them up when I remember my secret.
Ha ha ha.
Of course we
We don't want to leave any of you, but especially...
Settled down to new prosperity. In time, Molly and I were married. Long John Sliver stayed and became a reformed character, with the help of my mother, of course. And slowly, our great adventure became history.
Bye. Katie did all the work. I simply send out the bossy emails. But this cast have worked incredibly hard. It's really tricky not to have the stage until the dress rehearsal. They've managed it. And I have to say that SCIDS will never give Bernie the boot. Because he works so hard. I have to thank very, very carefully my own daughter, Sally, because she and her family do all the words of the songs on holiday. And then we have to thank Kirsty, because she makes the words fit the music. So they work incredibly hard all the way through the year. And the very last person that I do also want to just draw to your attention that the rector's got 4 services tomorrow. So I'm not quite sure how she's going to make it. But the challenge is for her to do it in this costume.
I'll give it a go.
But know. I mean, and anybody in this village, there are lots of villagers here, I'm sure, tonight, and anybody who would ever imagine that the new River Room competes with the village hall must be quite bonkers, because this hall needs to be robust. The River Room will fit a completely different role, so don't ever listen to gossip that says they're competition. They're not. And the last person I want to thank, and I'm really sorry because I'm going to do this, because he over there puts up with a year of my scribbling the script, going on at him, talking to see whether the lines are funny or not. So, and thank you, Alan, for all the support.
Jason, the doll? Jason, the doll? Oh, the doll, Papa. Oh, it's Papa.